Do you know what sucks? Like really sucks? Getting a new pair of football boots in the wrong size is what sucks. I mean, you're all excited. It's literally one of the worst things that can happen when you get a new pair of boots. But sadly, it's one of the most common mistakes you can make in terms of getting the most out of your new pair of football boots. But no more, I say, because today, I'm gonna teach you how to get the right and proper size when you buy a new pair of boots. But before we get started, how about that you hit that subscribe button? Did you do it? Good. The first thing you want to look at in order to get the right size in your boots is length. Football boots are made to give you a tight and snug fit. And in these days of anatomically shaped boots, you want your football boot to really follow the shape of your foot closely in order to get the best performance. Plus, if your boots are too big and have a too roomy toe box, your foot might slide around inside of it, which not only lowers the responsiveness, but also the comfort. So don't just go with that age-old rule that your dad probably told you where you need to have a thumb's room of wiggle space inside the toe box. What you do want is the size and the length where your boots will fit you as snug as possible while still being comfortable. Of course, it shouldn't be so tight that it actually hurts or is uncomfortable in any way, or anywhere for that matter, but you still want that extremely tight and snug fit so you and your feet and your boots won't feel chunky when you play, and so that you feel strapped in and ready to perform for the entire 90 minutes. Or if you're like me, well, you get sopped off after 70. So in order to find your right length, you need to measure your foot and obviously find out how long it is. Mine is 24.7 centimeters, which usually means that I'm a UK 6 or a Europe 40. But because the UK and US and Europe sizes sometimes vary between the brands, I tend to use the Japanese size, where I'm a size 250, just to be on the safe side because I know it always works for me. Or you can do the even more easy thing and actually use the Unisport size guide, where we've hand measured more or less all the boots that we have on stock. And it's super easy, it's nice, it works, and you can find it right under the box where you select your size on this site. Couldn't be easy. Now that you know your right length and thus your right size, it's time to figure out if the boot that you really want is even good for the shape of your foot. Because what you should never, ever, ever, ever do is to go up half a size or even a full size to accommodate a wide foot. Because if a boot is too tight or narrow, it hurts and you have the right length, it's just simply not the boot for you, and it might suck if you have a boat of a wide foot like Jolter and you really love the Vapor. But tell you what, it's not worth sacrificing the right size and the right fit over looks or whatever reason you might have to want to play in the Vapor. But Jay, how do I know if I have wide feet? Well, if you for one can't tell simply by looking at it, I mean, looking at Jolter's feet is pretty obvious. But if you can't tell, you can measure it on the widest part of the foot. And then you can go and look up a chart on the interwebs where you can see if your foot width is narrow, normal, or wide compared to your foot length. And actually, I'm gonna put a link in the description to the chart that I use, which tells me that my 24.7 foot is narrow to normal, which is good because that's what I expected. But now that you know your length and your width, it's time to go and get down to the business and find the right boot for you. Okay, so you found out that you have a wide foot, but you still really, really, really want that super slim Mercurial Vapor 11. But seriously, guys, don't. I know it's difficult, but if you do have a wide foot and you get the wrong boot, it's only gonna cause you pain and trouble, and you probably have to get a new one. So instead, go for a boot that is naturally wide, like the Evo Power Vicar, or the Opus, or the Hypervenom 3, or the Evo Power, or any other boot that is naturally wide. You can check out Jolter's top 5 wide boots by clicking the eye on your screen right now. But the best thing to do in order to figure out if the boot is the right size and the right width for you is actually try them out a bit around the house when you get them. Because you can bet your balls that if the size is wrong and they feel tight or hurt around the house, they're gonna be 10 times worse when you hit the pitch. And you don't want that. In short, size and fit is king. And if you get this wrong and the boots are too roomy or too tight, you're simply gonna be cheating yourself out of a better playing experience. So be honest with yourself and what you need and what you like to go and find the right size. And once you've done that, make sure to go and watch our video on how to then get the perfect fit. You're welcome. But guys, let me know in the comment section right down below what the stupidest thing you've done is in regards to sizing. I've made a few, so I'm excited to hear what you have to say. Also, don't forget to subscribe by clicking the green bubble right up there. Leave me a like if you had a good time, and don't forget to spread the word by sharing the video with your friends. And with that said, I'm signing off.